हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी विल रिवाइज द टॉपिक रिवीजन ऑफ कंप्रेशन फॉर क्लास फिफ्थ। लेट्स स्टार्ट द रिवीजन ऑफ कंप्रेशन। read the passage and answer those following questions are given below. First is, my pet dog Bhurya is Doberman. It is my most faithful companion. It shows its affection by wagging its tail and licking my face and hands. Bhurya is always happy to follow me everywhere. Sometimes it plays with my shoes or bring the ball wanting me to play with it. It also wait at the front door looking forward to welcome me when I come back from school. As soon as it hear the sound of newspaper man's cycle, Bhurya starts barking. It brings the newspaper inside. Every morning, one day, we were awakened by Bhurya's loud barking. My father and I went out of the house to find out. We saw a kitten on the mat of our front door. Seeing us, Bhurya started licking the kitten. We understood it wanted to take care of it. So now we are the proud owner of two pets, a dog and a cat. Bhurya has taught us to be kind to all animals. Now, questions and answers. Choose the correct option to complete the following. First, my pet dog Bhurya is a dash. Spider-Man. B. Pokoman. C. Doberman. Here, the words which are in purple color is the answer of the sentence. My pet dog Bhurya is a Doberman. Bhurya shows its affection by wagging its tails. B. Ears. C. Eyes. The correct answer is tails. Bhurya started licking the dash. A. Kitten. B. Cub. C. Kid. Here the correct answer is kitten. Bhurya taught us to be dash to all animals. Cruel. B. Naughty. C. Kind. Here the correct answer is kind. Bhurya wished to take care of dash. A. Kitten. B. Cub. C. Kid. B. Answer the following questions. Who was Bhurya? Author's pet dog Bhurya was a Doberman. How did Bhurya show its affection? Bhurya showed its affection by wagging its tail and licking author's face and hands. Third number, why did Bhurya start barking one night? Bhurya start barking one night because he saw a kitten on the mat of front door. Fourth number, why was Bhurya licking the kitten? Bhurya was licking the kitten because he wanted to take care of the kitten. What had Bhurya taught us? Bhurya had taught us to be kind to all animals. Bhurya had taught us to be kind to all us. Second number, passage second. In a small town of Odisha, a huge tree stood tall and straight. In the forest, its spreading branches were home to many birds. They used the twigs and leaves to make their nest. Squirrels chattered excitedly, and the marching ants posed to welcome when the children came. For Risha and Mana, the trees was their playmate. Risha is 12 years old and Mana is 10 years old. Their father had hung an old tire on one of the branch and made it into a tree swing. After school, they would rush to their playmate. First, they would leave some seeds and nuts for their animal friend, and then eat the fruits that their mother would pack for them. Then they would climb onto the tree swings, or sometimes just climb the trunk of the tree. Can you guess what the lines were for? It was for playing. They had drawn three lines on the trunk of the tree. Can you guess what the lines were for? It was for playing cricket. They practiced every day for 2 hours. Sometimes the neighbors and friends would also bring them food and water. After all, nothing should stop them from following their dream of joining the women's Indian cricket team. Question and answer. Choose the correct option to complete the following sentence. In a small town of Dash, a huge tree stood tall and straight in the forest. Odisha, B. Orisha, C. Odisha. The correct answer is Odisha. Risha is Dash years old. Here, 12 years, B. 13 years, C. 14 years. Here, the correct answer is 12 years. Mana is Dash years old. 10, B. 13, C. 14. The correct answer is 10. For Dash and Dash, tree was their playmate. For Dash and Dash, the tree was their playmate. Richa and Mania, Bhuria and Surya, C. Risha and Mana. Here, the correct answer is C. Risha and Mana. Risha and Mana practiced every day for 10 hours. 2, 4, 3. Here, the correct answer is 2. Answer the following questions. Where was a huge tree stood tall and straight? Answer is, in a small town of Odisha, a huge tree stood tall and straight in the forest. How did the bird make use of tree? The spreading branches of tree were home to many birds. They used the twigs and leaves to make their nest. Third number, how did Risha and Mana make use of the tree? For Risha and Mana, the tree was their playmate. Fourth number, what was Risha and Mana's dream? Risha and Mana's dream of joining the women's Indian cricket team. Mugi was a little green dragon who lived with his large family in a cave on the mountainside. Here the question is asked as a who was Mugi? Here Mugi was a little green dragon. Where did Mugi lived? Here the answer of the question is like Mugi lived with his large family in a cave on the mountain side. If the question is asked as a complete the line with the help of the option. Here like Mugi lived with his dash family. Here the answer is large family. Mugi was a little green dragon who lived with his large family in a cave on the mountainside. Since there were a lot of little cousins, one of the older dragons held a class every morning to teach them how to blow flames out of their mouths and noses and how to fly. After all, dragon had to do all kinds of work when they grew up. But Mugi was sitting in a corner looking miserable. Here miserable, that means unhappy. He did not know how to fly, and what was worse, he could not blow flames out of his nostril or mouth. When the other dragons had gone away, he practiced in the meadow. A hawk had been watching him and realized that the little dragon needed help. He swooped down and sat on a tree trunk. "You are doing it all wrong," he told Mugi, and slowly he began to teach Mugi how to fly. It was very difficult, but after about a week, Mugi could lift off the ground, and soon he was soaring above the tree. What a fantastic feeling it was! And he was so delighted with his success that he let out a great whoop. And do you know what happened? He actually shot out flames. He was really dragon, and he even had a friend, the walk. Now question and answer. Choose the correct option to complete the following sentence. Dash was a little green dragon who lived with his large family. Here the options are Muni, B, Nanu, C, Mugi. Here the words in purple color are the answer of the question. Here the correct answer is Mugi. Mugi was lived in a cave on the dash. This question is in the first two lines of the passage. Mugi was lived in a cave on the mountainside, B, lakeside, C, riverside. Here Mugi was lived in a cave on the mountain. Second, Mugi was lived in a cave on the dash. Here, the correct answer is mountain side. Third number, Dash was sitting in a corner looking miserable. Here, the option are Mugi, B, Hog, C, Nanu. Here, the correct answer is Mugi. Mugi was sitting in a corner looking miserable. Fourth number, a dash had been watching him and realized the little dragon needed help. Here, the option are Mugi, B, Hog, C, Nanu. Here, the correct answer is Hog. A hog had been watching him and realized that the little dragon needed help. Fifth number, a hog swooped down and sat on a dash. A. Tree trunk, B. Mountain peak, C. Hillside. Here, the correct answer is a trunk. A tree trunk. A hawk swooped down and sat on a tree trunk. Now, P. Answer the following question. That one is, who was Mugi? Here, the question is asked with WH word who. So, we write down the name of the person or animals as a character of the story. Here we write down the name of the first animal who was Mugi. Mugi was a little green dragon. Where did Mugi live? Here the question is asked with WH word where. So we write down the name of the place where Mugi lived. Here Mugi lived with his large family in a cave on the mountain side. Who teach Mugi how to fly? Here the name of the person who teach Mugi how to fly. Here a hawk slowly began to teach Mugi how to fly. Fourth number, why was Mugi unhappy? Mugi was unhappy because he did not know how to fly. And what was the worst? He could not blow flames out of his nostril or mouth. Repeat again, my dear. Why was Mugi unhappy? Mugi was unhappy because he did not know how to fly, and what was worse, he could not blow flames out of his nostril or mouth. Why did the old dragon hold classes? The old dragons held the class every morning to teach little dragon how to fly and how to blow flames out of their mouths and noses. The old dragon held the class every morning to teach little dragon how to fly and how to blow flames out of their mouths and noses. Okay, my dear, I hope that you have learned this topic, the revision of comprehension, and you will write down all this question answer, or also after this video given the three comprehension and read that passage and answer the following questions in your notebook. Thank you very much.